Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Oh my. Here we go. I'm extremely grateful that all of you woke up so early to join me this morning here at the Entrepreneur's Sandbox. This is my first time here. I hear from the conversations with Meredith that they built this space in 10 months. Yes. Can they house homeless people too in 10 months?
That'd be
real, maybe. Just a few house things. Today is also the climate change strike, the walkout. So, I mean, I think some of you have jobs. Let's do that. Where's my NMG people at? Like, we can all walk out precisely at 4 o'clock, a very timed act of rebellion around 4 p.m. and a very controlled walk to the governor's house, to the Halle, and make sure we're using all the sidewalks very properly, a very controlled act of rebellion. Okay, sorry. Sarcasm, pal. All right, I'm just gonna go through this really quickly. I've had a few keynotes where I shared the work that I've done in the 39 years that I've existed on this human planet. But what I wanted to share, something a little bit different. I think we're picking up some radio signals, aren't we, Romina? You hear some music, it's okay, it's only us, yeah. Hello, salutations. One of my best friends shared this reading, and that inspired kind of like this umbrella, this theme of Muse that the Creative Mornings, thank you again to Creative Mornings and Meredith and Noah for putting this together. So we start with MMM. I thought it was beautiful, this little typeface. I'm obsessed with those two dots right now. Is the mother of the Muses. So I'm gonna start with that. So what I'm gonna try to do is get a little bit deeper into some of my origin stories. And I'm just gonna go through my things here. So from this reading, if Hunter could remind me where this passage is from, because I can't read that micro text. It's from Georgie, okay. To learn by heart is to afford the text or music an indwelling clarity and life force. What we know by heart becomes an agency in our consciousness. How ironic, I can't even remember this. A pacemaker in the growth and vital complication of our identity. Throughout human history, the memorizing song and written and stories is a part of human communication and connection. What I took from that was the memory of the visual experience. That my way of seeing is a library, a collection of references, visual references that span a very short lifetime. I mean, I'm only 39. It's there's still so much to see and learn. And so that's kind of like what I wanted to share with you this morning is, again, I'm going to go through some background, some origin stories, and share with you a quick video montage of some of my cinema influences that have basically created this library of visual attentiveness. And hopefully you can... puzzle together my unique way of seeing. I don't know if some of you even bother to watch some of my Instagram stories, but I am obsessed with the esoteric and the random and all things made human. So this photo that I took of my family's home, I think most people think that I was born in Hawaii. I'm actually born in the Philippines. That experience has defined my way of maneuvering through different types of spaces. This memory right here is the space in between the different houses in my grandfather's land, and it's really I thought it was really interesting because it was a very a scary and dark and dingy little alley, and but for me, looking at this memory in this film photo with this light, it kind of like for me defines like these dark spaces that have filled my imagination. Here is your typical street vendor in the Philippines, and I thought it was really cute that this dog is just waiting for a juicy morsel to fall on the floor, and your vendor kind of just like very lazy sitting down and cooking some fish balls, possibly. So this is the house that I grew up in. Music was a big part of growing up and singing karaoke and renting these karaoke machines was a big part of my passion for music making also. I remember a tricycle would drop this TV Frankenstein off at my house. Look at it. It's a TV haphazardly attached to some kind of video game. I shot this with Ektar 100, so lovely types of high contrasts of color kind of naturally came through. I'm trying to make sure I'm following my theme here. Okay, so some more of origins. Thank you, Romina. Here is here's my father in our farmland, and he's very happy holding the Nara tree that he planted. I do have fantasies of moving back to the Philippines and building a house next to the stream at the end of this land. And that's going to also be determined if the Democrats do very well in 2020. Okay, so I think my buddy here, Joey, has some ins. Joey, are you here? Raise your hand. You got some ins in the Philippines Consulate General. I think I do think we had a conversation about dual citizenship. Oh, shitzel. Okay, crappers. I just ruined it. So my father didn't want to be ruled under the Marcos regime. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that. So he decided to quit the Philippine army and instead joined the good guys. And he joined the US Army. And when I was 7, he illegally PCS'd us out of the Philippines. Meaning we illegally moved to a different country. My immediate family, myself, my parents, and my then 1-year-old baby brother. And I went from this balmy, third world, amazing wilderness where I was running around, coming home at like when the sun comes down, dirty, filled with mud, and surrounded by dozens of family members, aunts, cousins that like took care and doted on me, and to this. This is I moved. We moved to Germany in the Kaiserslautern area and to a town called Rammstein, and lived in Rammstein and Landstuhl for so from eight when the Berlin Wall came down. So can you imagine, like, to be separated from family, and you know what that really is it's a bit of culture shock. So I've had, which I think is the main thing about this unique experience that I have, that I've been actually blessed, now that I can say that I've been blessed to what I feel like the universe, kind of as if a tornado paving a path from the Philippines to Europe. We also moved to Maryland for a little bit in Prince George County, and then back again to the Philippines because my family thought I was losing my culture, and then finally deciding to plant roots here in Hawaii. So this little girl experienced a lot of culture shock, and I lived through these types of castles, and this was a castle that was on top of the mountain that I lived in. And I remember just kind of like having like these affinity towards like gothic things and dark things and scary things, and like my mind was just filled with fantasies of witches. Witches was a part of the culture in Germany. We had like a whole holiday just for witches, and that was just like a regular thing. And I think that was where those fantasies of being goth came from. And I thought it'd be actually funny to juxtapose this photo with this next photo next to this other castle. That's me. Look at that face. So sour already. Sour from day one. Sour from day one. Face like this from day one. So my entire life really revolved around the base, the military base, and so for me, I found I was a very quiet and very rebellious child. I've always had a disdain towards authority, I think. So I escaped to this place. So this is a photo, thanks to the internet, the actual Rammstein library, public library in the base. And in this place, I think at least twice a week, especially on Sundays after church, my family would go to this library, and I would just immerse myself in books and fill my mind with, you know, Laura Ingalls Wilder, all those prairie books, and Where the Red Fern Grows was a big thing, and sci-fi books came to play, R.L. Stine came to play, and you know, as curiosity goes, I'm quite certain that I've found a few large format hardbound books on erotic art, and that was kind of like a gateway to finding the photography section and the art section of the library. So yeah, now I'm just going to kind of build up to, so imagine, right? My family was quite conservative, church school. Succeeding was a very big part in my family's, especially my father's perception of me. At a very early age, he had incepted this idea that his dream was to salute to his daughter. And that was like a very important part of how I was growing up, because I got more affection from, you know, Asian families. A lot of them don't give a lot of affection. That I received affection as a reward for succeeding. So that I knew if I got straight A's, that I knew I'd probably get a hug. I'd get a hug or a pat on the back and a thumbs up. And so for me, succeeding was such a big deal, right? And so, again, at a very early age, I experienced this thing. From the ages, I'm going to actually say 11. I don't know. From 14 to 39, just this feeling of angst, which, you know, like, it really just led me to, again, immersing myself in the visual world of music. Music was such a big deal. Listening to the radio was such a big deal, and recording music through tape was such a big deal, and slowing it down just enough so I could really understand what those Bone Thugs and Harmony verses were. If I just slowed it down just enough, I could make out, I don't know. A feeling of deep anxiety or dread, angst. Typically, this is really me, typically an unfocused one about the human condition or the state of the world in general. Ara, in short, is this definition, absolutely. So, in the library, you could also rent movies. I don't know if you guys know that. You could actually rent tapes and those big discs that had movies in them. What do you call those?
Last night I made you a film montage of some of the movies that have defined I think who I am today. You know, all the things that Meredith said, that the things that I can do, especially art making, styling, design, teaching, are all archetypes of characters in movies that I want to live every day, that I believe I am every day. Mm-hmm. And so let's go through some of this. Hopefully the sound will work. And that's when you press the button in the middle. Let's do it.
Did you really think you could bear the Kwisatz Haderach? The universe is a super being.
Title sequence for I Am Love, the type on this changed my perception of what type could look like with video. I just love the contrast in colors in this sequence. I think I've watched this a million times. Just, it's just a regular street. obviously Breathless is...
New York Herald Tribune!
Godard was a huge influence.
New York Herald Tribune!
I was this character for a long time.
Vanya Hall.
I know, I'm sorry, like, some of these sounds will be off, but... I don't know why I'm talking. You should let them listen to it. What the fuck am I talking for? Turn up that sound.
Lors de Marseille, je restais samedi et dimanche à Monte Carlo, fallait que je voie un type. Lundi, j'ai essayé de t'appeler de Marseille.
Lundi et dimanche, t'es pas à Paris.
New York Herald Tribune!
Symmetry on this is amazing.
Can you mix a martini?
Sure.
I'll do it.
Oh.
I make a fabulous martini.
I love this movie.
Everybody should have one talent. What's yours?
Forging signatures, telling lies, impersonating practically anybody.
That's three.
Also known as a designer.
You should have more than one talent. Okay. Do an impression.
Now?
May I introduce Miss Eliza Doolittle?
My dear Miss Doolittle, how kind of you to let me come.
Delighted, my dear.
I just love the fact that she had such a thick Cockney accent.
How do you
and
do?
Oh, we're going to Roma.
Hey, bellezza.
Hey, guarda che cool.
Good old objectification of women. It's lovely.
Buongiorno.
I swear.